Do you believe that success in mathematics is down to natural ability or to hard work and practice? And what do your students believe? Do they think that you're either good at maths or not and there's nothing you can do about it? G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Professor Pete's Classroom. Welcome to Mathematics in the News. This week we're looking at an article from the TES in the UK entitled How Everyone Can Succeed at Maths. That's coming up right after this. This article is aimed at classroom teachers of maths and encourages every teacher to believe in the future success of his or her students. The author of the article, Tony Staniff, is the vice principal of a school in Halifax, UK. He describes his first year of teaching, where he was given a class in the middle range of ability and was told not to expect them to achieve better than a D. Well, after taking the attitude that every child could achieve success and not setting limits on what they could do at the end of his period of time of teaching them, every student got at least a C and some of them got a B. The program described in this article is entitled Maths Everyone Can, and its core message is summed up in these three components: practice of the right kind, hard work, maximum effort, and belief, believe that you can do it. I love this. These three points summarize the most important critical points to developing successful learners of mathematics. Basically, the teacher has to provide the right sort of practice, the student has to commit to working hard, and everyone, the teacher, the students, and the parents, must expect success. I believe that the teachers at the White Rose Maths Hub are directing the focus of their program at the heart of the issue. We must all agree that every child can do maths, every child can succeed at maths, and no one is rubbish at maths. I love this quote attributed to Henry Ford: if you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. We don't actually know if it was Henry Ford who said that. There's some evidence that other people said it before him. But it's such a good summary of the idea that if you believe that you can succeed, if you believe in your own ability, you're far more likely to succeed than if you believe you're a failure. Speaking personally, I'm delighted to support and endorse this approach to the teaching of mathematics. In fact, several years ago, my wife and I decided to adopt as the mission and the business slogan for our business, every child can succeed at K-6 mathematics. So what's your experience of developing success in your students, and how do they respond to it? What do they believe about their own success or lack of it? Do leave a comment below the video. I'd love to start a conversation about this topic with you. If you like this video and you'd like to see others like it, then do click this subscribe button right here and YouTube will send you notification when new videos come out. You can also click on these links over here and you can open another video immediately. I encourage you to come to our website, it's profpete.com, where you can access quality resources for teaching K-6 mathematics, all developed with mathematical understanding as their goal and in the belief that every child can succeed at K-6 mathematics. That's it from me. I'd love to talk to you again soon in another video.